Look up, Joe.
The lips. Your lips.
Wait, what?
Yes.
The scissors are on there.
Wow, look at the bride.
Here comes the bride.
Here comes the bride. Here comes the bride.
Wow.
My JT.
Thank you.
Oh, oh,
Yeah, Joe is ready to be here.
Is that okay?
Yeah. We'll be going to the farm one, and then I'll be moved to the Northgate one.
Oh, yeah.
No way. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, then so get to London.
Yeah, yeah. It's quite a place, cool place.
Yeah, borderline London.
God, guys, but I don't become like, I don't let it become like a.
I went to, what's the name, what do you call it again?
Emotional. It's suddenly.
You've been through me through hard times, man. I really appreciate a lot, man. Michael, same for you, bro. Demi, you've been away a lot, but thanks for coming and making this journey here. Jahir, obviously, similar to Dan. James, money for years, bro. Love you, bro. Dan, same for you, bro.
I'm only getting to know you, man, but like, you're cool as well.
And Emily, thanks for coming as well.
That's alright. Happy wedding day.
Eugene,
yeah.
I think we're gonna head over.
Okay.
Pull it up a little bit. That's it.
Look up.
What church are you going
to? Yeah.
Home. Ah, oh, cool. It's just payday, baby. Payday?
Wait. Do you want this thing closed? Yeah. It's going to be closed, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay.
That's a nice shoes.
For ages. Why did you have a coupling in the same room on this? For. Did they plan to get married? Let's do the before and after.
Yeah, I'm sure it's going to be a lot neater.
We cleaned this whole house up yesterday. Now it's a tip again already.
Yeah. There's a hairdresser.
Yeah.
Getting married. Hallelujah.
Who's getting married?
Come on.
Look, we get good on camera.
Well done. Good one.
You too, congratulations.
Hey, Joseph, how's it going?
Have we met?
Yeah. Tony, nice to meet you, man.
Cool, congratulations.
You should be giving someone else your phone.
Ah, I see, okay.
They're in the. You think it hangs, but the spiritual tends to be much
better. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, how are you all doing?
We are fine.
All right.
How you
doing? Okay.
Good.
Afternoon. How you doing, guys? You alright?
Yeah, blessed, man. How you doing?
Yeah, good.
It's Joel's wedding, man.
Yeah.
Hey, Joel,
you're married, man.
Very nice touch.
Thanks.
There's got to be a registry.
He must have paid God something.
Yeah, I don't know about that. But I don't see it nowhere else where except for that.
Yeah.
Is there nowhere else?
God bless, man. Yeah, man, yeah.
Oh,
I've never seen this stage on the set, man. Who are you, man? You look like royalty.
You good?
God bless you, man.
How are you? Nice to meet you.
Yeah. You're right, mate.
You doing, bro? You doing, man?
Nice to meet you.
Hi,
Becky. Yeah. How are you feeling, man?
I'm good, man. We need to go in because we need to do the flowers.
Is you there as well?
No, the trick is don't look.
Yeah.
Always look, keep it there. Look there.
Keep it there, yeah.
You know.
I know. Yeah, no, man, I don't know.
I'm not going to ask for who.
Okay.
Yeah.
The honor for the opening prayer to invite a minister who also happens to be the groom's father, just retired Reverend David Swains, is going to open in prayer for us. Welcome, sir. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Pastor Touch, and thank you so much for being here for us all today. Let us pray. Almighty God, as we gather together, we bring you our thanks and our praise for this wonderful day and this wonderful occasion. We thank you for the gift and joy of family life. We thank you for giving Joe and Rebekkah to their families. And now we thank you that you are bringing them together as a new family. Thank you for the gift of marriage, that it's not something which we devised or invented, but part of your plan of blessing for humankind. Lord, we pray that you will bless our time together, bless this ceremony, and most of all, bless Joe and Rebekkah as they take this first momentous step in a new life that will last until the end of their life together. We thank you for all this, and we commit everything to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Rob. Thank you so much. We really appreciate that. Okay, now the moment we've all been waiting for, I know for a fact you didn't travel from far and near just to see me. Definitely not. Okay, we will be welcoming the bride. and the bridal train. So I'm going to request you, please, to stand as we...
Rebekkah, Sarah, Cecilia, George, Charles. Yeah.
As my wife.
As my wife.
Today.
Today.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
For better and in plenty.
For better and in plenty.
In health.
In health.
And in all circumstances.
In all circumstances.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
According to the will of God.
According to the will of God.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And the church said,
Amen.
Okay. Now Rebekkah, Sarah, Cecilia, George, Charles. You want to tell me? I. Your name, yes.
Rebekkah, Sarah, Cecilia, George, Charles.
Today.
Accept you, Joseph Swales.
Accept you, Joseph Swales.
As my husband.
As my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
For better and in plenty.
For better and in plenty.
In health.
In health.
And in all circumstances.
In all circumstances.
I will cherish and obey you.
I will cherish and obey you.
According to the will of God.
According to the will of God.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
God helping me.
God helping me.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the church said,
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, Baya, we will get to the rings, not just yet. We will get to that, not just yet. Now, by our commission, I have to give you the view. You'll have to exchange the Bible first before the rings. Yeah. So, give you that Bible. So, you're going to hand it over to her. You don't have to open it. So. With this Bible,
which is the Word of God,
I pledge, and I surrender myself to you, Rebekkah, Sarah, Cecilia, George, Charles.
Rebekkah, Sarah, Cecilia, George, Charles.
And I will cherish you.
And I will cherish you
with all my love.
With all my love
and possessions.
And possessions.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Okay then. The rings. Do we have the rings?
We do have them, Dana.
Okay. Okay. And I give you this ring.
And I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
I choose you to be my wife.
I choose you
and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Okay. And then.
Joseph Swales.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Wear it.
With love and joy.
I choose you.
I choose you.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Now, before I pray, I understand you might also have some words you want to say to each other.
Wow.
Yes. Wow. Keep it short and sweet. I know you're an evangelist, wow. But please. Go
away. Rebekkah, Cecilia, and George Charles. Within about 3 weeks of knowing you, I knew I wanted to spend the rest of my life with you. You're my best friend. You're the answer to many years of praying. You're the greatest gift God could ever give me. The thoughtfulness you show me and many others is something I've never experienced from anyone before. Your smile is beautiful. The love that I feel from you every time I spend time with you makes me feel so special. I love your cute East London accent. I love the way that you say, my yard, I love your gentle spirit. If I'm your Boaz, you're my Rebekkah. No matter whatever we come against in our marriage, I promise to wash you with the word of God, to help build you spiritually, to spend quality time with you, to never take you for granted, to pray with you every day so that the enemy will have no foothold on us. Your Proverbs 31 go for sure. I promise to always be yours, and yours only. Jesus instructs me with the Bible to wash you with the word of God. I promise to love you like Christ loved the church. This is a vow I promise to fulfill to the best of my ability. I will fly the plane, but you're the best co-pilot I could ever ask for. I promise to not take advantage of you, to walk all of you. Less of me, less of I, and more of we. We're finally here. Who would have thought after that first day with me, eating wrong food, where I told a little white lie to make you go on a date with me? We're eating Chinese food and chopsticks, we complain about how bad our exes have been to us. But, like Christ loved the church, I've always been back first. You sound like Devlin, please move out of Dagman. People stare, but I don't care. God, answer my prayer and make a good day.
Started this journey, I've had the Bible verse Jeremiah 29:11 in my heart, and today as we stand together as one, I pray we continue to live by this verse as we go through our marriage together. I cannot believe I found someone who is thoughtful, caring and loving. The love and grace you show for God, people and me is something special. So I promise to love you each and every day. I promise to listen to you as you speak. I promise to share quiet time with you as we read the Bible together. And I promise to love you without hesitation or boundaries for the rest of my life.
Okay. Now, for this cause, shall a man leave his father and mother? I think they were glad when you left. I'll be glad when you leave the church. I'm just teasing. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and the two shall be one flesh.
Amen.
So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Now, as Father Joseph Swings and Sister Rebekkah Sawa Cecilia Georgecharles have agreed to be joined in holy matrimony, even as they have confessed this before God and men, backed up with the giving and receiving of the Holy Bible as an everlasting testament, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And you may now kiss the bride. Just for the sake of time. Thank you. Perfect representation of God's love to the church. You know what Jesus has done for us? When God sent his son and he died for us, so that he took away all of our sin, even when we don't deserve it. There is no greater love than this, than a man lays life down for his friend. Jesus does not see you as only servants, but as friends. And just like the marriage that God has ordained between Rebecca, Cecilia, I can't remember, but Jill Swales. So when their marriage is the glory of God, is the perfect representation of God's love to the church. You know, when they have been married, they now become one. They were separate before. Like, even in the world where everyone marries, we all come together, but we don't come in as like, okay, two separate people. But they come together and become one. So that even her body and her wholeness belongs to Joe. And Joe himself belongs to her. And now whatever decision they make it in unity. They make it in love. They make it in the truth of the Word of God. They live for one another, but living unto God. And I feel by the Spirit, just to share with you Ephesians 5, but that's, none of these are prepared, but I believe, just to encourage you, so that what God sees, what marriage is, so that you shall understand and experience the same, because Jesus loves every single one of you, and he wants the very same thing for you, to come to him, to repent, go away from all your old ways, and turn to him, because nothing on earth will satisfy you. But who will is only Jesus. Amen. So let's read Ephesians 5. And have a listen to this very carefully and take this in. Because this is God's word. Because God wants you to know him completely. Okay? Amen. So Ephesians 5. I'm still looking, guys, so you have to be very patient. Good with turning pages. Okay.
Okay, Ephesians 5 says the following, and he's talking about husbands and wives and about the real marriage that God has given. And what is it supposed to look like? Okay, so it says here from verses 22. Now for wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord. For a husband is the head of his wife, as Christ is the head of the church. So Rebekkah, she submits to Job, because as Job submits himself unto the Lord.
Amen.
And then he himself leads her, and he takes the lead, and she follows because she's following Christ.
Amen.
And then he is the savior of his body. The church, which is Jesus, is the savior of our body. As the church submits to Christ, so you wives submit to your husbands in everything. For husbands, this means love your wives, just as Christ loved the church. He gave up his life for her to make her holy and clean, and washed her by the cleansing of God's word.
Amen.
He did this to present her to himself as a glorious church without spot or wrinkle or any other blemish. Instead, she will be holy and without fault. Husbands, you ought to love their wives as they love their own bodies, as same as the wife should do to her husband. So we just thank God for that he has brought together, you know, two people for the glory of God and for the goodness of God. And we just want to pray, and everybody with your hearts, just stretch out your hands and be in agreement as we pray for them. And Lord, we thank you for, Lord, we thank you for everything that you've done, God. You are so faithful and you are so good. Like, Lord, that you never let anyone down. And Lord, we give you all the glory and the thanks that you have brought together a man and a woman of God whose heart is sold out to you, that they may live for you in obedience, in sacrifice unto you completely, that they will no longer live a life unto their own, but as unto the Lord. So Lord, I pray that Job, that he will love Rebekkah as Lord Christ loves the church. And Rebekkah will submit to him as unto the Lord and follow his lead as he follows Jesus. So Father, give them wisdom from heaven, understanding, knowledge of what you want them to do and accomplish your will on earth as it is in heaven. So we thank you, Lord, that you made this way. And Lord, even if their backs were against the wall and they didn't know it was going to happen, but you made a way. So Father, we thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that from now and forever, they are one flesh. In Jesus' name, we give glory to God. Amen.
Amen. Come on, let's appreciate Evangelist Jaher Israel. Hallelujah. Okay, we almost there. I'm going to invite the band. They're going to sing a special song, Waymaker, and then the couple will have their dance, and then after that there will be announcement, then there will be recess. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
So please, let's rejoice with them. Let's rise on our feet.
Miracle worker, promise healer, by the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
I'm now just about to invite Mr. Eugene, who's going to give us announcements. Please, brethren, please do not go just yet. Wait for the recess, please. Wait for the recess. So announcements won't be that long. And I know I did say all protocols observed, but there's something embedded in me. You know, as a young African boy, anytime I don't acknowledge the elders, I still feel bad. I mean, it's the way I was brought up. So I want to acknowledge Rebekkah's Nana and Granddad. Yeah, let's clap for them. Thank you so much.
Amen.
I think to the photographers, you know, later when they're taking the picture, they should do one of those pictures where they do three generations.
That's fine. I just want to thank, Pastor said that, but I want to thank everyone for coming. You're all looking wonderful, beautiful, beautiful weather, and it's just perfect. So thank you once again. Fortunately, this is not the end. We call it part two or version two, and that will be the reception. There is, for those of you who don't know where it is, there is this little slip just by the offering box at the back. So if you want more information, it's here, but I'll read it out anyway. So the reception is not far, it's about 5 minutes from here, and it's starting at 5 p.m. So there is a bit of a wait, but you can go there, have your seats.
If people don't want to go for pictures.
Right, so he's spoken. If you don't want to go for pictures, you can head straight there, sit down, make yourself comfortable, there'll be nice music playing, and everything.
We ask the caterers to serve canapés and drinks as soon as people arrive.
So there's food. So, right, so you can go there and have a little meal to have while you're there. It's at the Stanway Community Hall, and it's about 5 minutes from here. It's interesting, the postcode's not here. I will look it up and find a way to get it to you. So yeah, put Stanway Community Hall on Google Maps and you'll find it there. The groom asked for a favor. You saw the lovely band that was here and they did a wonderful ministration. Thank you, that was excellent. And I'm sure you're not aware of it, but he's asked if you feel that you've been blessed by them, because they came just purely for this. They came together and they're not being paid anything, and it was just a way of saying thank you to Joe and Rebekkah. So he's asked if it's possible to, and if you're willing, for a little collection for them. So we have people who are gonna try to sort that out, but they'll probably bring a bag or something if you can. If not, not compose you or whatever, but just I'll say that as well. So right after this, I'd like to ask, if you don't mind, we give the bridal train, which I'm part of, awesome. Yes, so there'll be one more song while they're doing the offering. So after all of this, we'll give the bridal train, the honors to let them, walk out before we leave as well, if you don't mind. And then that will be it. And by the powers vested in me, I will close this service. But thank you all once again. Thank you.
If people want the address for where we're taking the pictures and want to come and have a picture, get it from Eugene after the service. After the wedding.
The same thing.
Well, if it's possible to put all the details also on the project out there,
find out.
That's fine.
Yeah,
let's welcome the band again.
Yeah. Oh, no, you've
got it. Beautiful. Is it? Send it to him. Send it to him.
Everybody, can everybody stand while we're doing the song and give God all the glory for today, our wedding day.
blinded by your grace, by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace, by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace. Lord, I've been broken, although I'm not worthy. You fix me, I'm blinded by your grace. You came and saved me, Lord, I've been broken. And one round of applause, and one time for the cause, and one shout to Isaac on the drums. I think we got this, I stay prayed until we got the job done. Yeah, I'm Kimberly's you, but I've got to. Now real talk, look at what we've got it. Now real talk, look at what we've got it. On this main stage here with my suit on, I know Betsy, I know that we got this. You the devil, he's never gonna stop this. White pray right here, you can stop my birth. This is the it's and it is your birth. It is by grace and it is by birth. Oh my God, what God we serve.
Lord, I've been broken.
Grace, right? None of us are worthy of his grace.
Come on.
There's people, I know there's people that don't believe in God, right? But honestly, don't be an idiot. This world wasn't just created from nothing. This world, there has to be a creator behind this world. It didn't come from nowhere. I didn't always believe in God, right? But age 19, after like just a life of sin that I was living, I loved my sin so much, trust me. But I someone prayed for my arm and I got healed. And from that day, I gave my life to Christ because I just knew the power of the Holy Spirit came over me. When these two people prayed for me, the Spirit of God came upon me. And it all just made sense. Everything my parents had tried to tell me, it made sense. So I gave my life to Christ. And there's people here that have been church hurt. There's a lot of churches that are that good, I'll be honest. There's a lot of bad churches out there, but there's a lot of good ones too. But don't just use like church hurt as an excuse to like not come to Christ, because Jesus loves you. And like, if you're not with him, if you're not with him now, why would he let you be with you in the afterlife? You know, hell is not a place where God is. It's a place where God isn't. So nobody knows when the last day is going to be. So I'm not going to do an altar call, but I'm just going to say, like, go away. If you don't believe in God, right, you're very stubborn and you're stuck in your sin and you love your sin so much, humble yourself. That's the piece of advice I'm going to give you all today, because some of you need to humble yourself and come to God, come to Christ. And if you want to get like Jameer, Yuji, Michael, anyone, we can after the wedding, we'll, at some point in the wedding, if anybody wants to give their lives to Christ, just talk to one of us and we'll help you, babe. We'll help you find a good church as well.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. What Joe said is a message of love, not just the one that they have for each other, but he knows that there is an even greater love, the love that God has for us, and he wants all of you to be part of it. So there are pastors here, and Joe's dad is also Pastor Reverend? Oh, I'm sorry. So there is more than enough opportunity, so reach out to any one of them, and I know God loves you. Yeah, this is it, and we'll ask the wonderful looking, what's it called? Groomsmen and bridesmaids to lead the way out. And
I think we're waiting.
Bride and groom, first of all, and then we're going to build up the picture.
Yes, love. You give it a little kiss. Yeah. Well, but it wasn't. Okay.
What the heck? I was really going to move.
At the waist, a little bit lower. Turn the shoulders around towards me. Turn, turn, turn. Hey, bring your flowers up a little bit higher. The waistline. That's it. Good. Lovely. Right there. Yeah, that's good. Simple. That's it. Lovely. Right there. Good. Lovely, before the sun changes. There, that's lovely. Okay. Gorgeous, right there. Okay. Okay, mum, that's it. Your face lights up and it smiles, baby. That's lovely. Grandma, get over here. Grandma, granddad.
I know you.
Excellent, right there. That's gorgeous. There. That's lovely. Okay, cool. All right, claim him. Yeah, that's good. Excellent. Gorgeous. Lovely. Okay, cool. There. There, lovely. You look fabulous. Put your hand in the pocket. And then turn sideways. That's it there. Perfect. Right there. Good. That's good. That's good. That's gorgeous. There. Turn around. You're out? Jen! Excellent, lovely, all fantastic. All looking good. What the? You mean? Ready! Ready, on me. Sounds good.